This is my home. Dishes, beauty products, boxes lying everywhere, and even old pizza left out from the night before. How did it get to this point? This box has been here for 3 months, unopened, with mail continuing to pile up. How? How did we let this clutter develop? This is the question that millions of individuals ask themselves when they open their closet and a mountain of clothes rains down upon them, or whenever they're late to work because they couldn't find their keys for the fifth time this week. This is my home, my sanctuary, my castle. How do I lose and get lost within it? My sanity. Freaking pizza.
But the good news is that none of that stuff was mine, and you can probably tell that that was my work area where I record a lot of my videos, and I'm washing my sheets right now, so that's why there's none on my bed. I like to keep my space fairly clean and clutter-free, but I have three other roommates, so it gets kind of difficult to keep the entire house clean. Every now and then I get frustrated with it and then clean up after them, but after so many tries of that, I've kind of given up. In my life, I kind of like trying to live like an essentialist. You can also call it minimalism, but I don't really like that term as much because it implies that you are trying to have as a minimal amount as possible. But what it really is holding on to what is essential to you. So you don't necessarily have to get rid of a lot of things, but you do need to keep only the things that are essential. And you not only need to look at the things in your life, but you also need to look at who you are letting into your life and what kind of activities that you are engaging in. Are they contributing value to your well-being? If not, then it might be a good idea to get rid of them or just not do those activities. But getting back to my space, the one area that I tend to have difficulty organizing is my closet. And that tends to be the case for a lot of people because they tend to just throw stuff in there that they don't need now, but that they think they might need in the future.
So I still have some decluttering that I need to do in the closet, and I also have some clothes that I need to get rid of. And before we get into that, well, there's two befores. First before is I have to say sorry to my mother because she buys me a lot of clothes, and I do wear a good majority of them, but there are some that I don't, so today you might see some of those get thrown away. And it's not that I didn't intend on wearing them whenever you first gave them to me, but I just have found myself not wearing them over the course of time. So sorry about that. And then the second before is that first I want to help you figure out how you should go about decluttering. So lately, the KonMari method has become popular due to this book and also the Netflix documentary on Marie Kondo. I also saw it Marie condo, so I'm not for sure which one is correct, or even if either of those are correct. Her method is pretty intense, and I didn't really like get into the book whenever I was reading it, but it is very effective in helping you kind of reset your house and help you get everything organized. So I would recommend it if you're someone that is super cluttery, just try and get it done in one flail, big swoop. But I'm obviously not that cluttered, so that's kind of why I didn't really take to that much, is because I don't really have much of a problem, but I still do have some things that I need to get rid of because they aren't essential to me. So the first thing that you want to do is start with getting rid of the easy stuff, because if you start with something that has a lot of sentimental value, then you'll experience a lot of resistance against getting rid of it because it's something that has some sort of memory attached to it and it's hard to get rid of. But if you start with something like clothes, or if you're attached to those, then maybe books if you're not attached to those, maybe even magazines. I mean, I don't have any magazines, but I watched a video earlier where a chick was throwing out her magazines, so I figured that might be the case for some of you. And like I said, I would still recommend doing this in one flail swoop. That way, after you have everything cleared out and organized, you don't have to worry about coming back the next week to continue organizing if you just do it in one big day or event. And then after that, you want to organize what you have left, because if it isn't organized and if something doesn't have a place in your room, then it's gonna end up getting cluttered because you'll throw your keys here, your wallet there, and then you'll end up losing them pretty much every single day. One of my old roommates, pretty much every single day, he would have to look for his wallet and keys for 5 minutes. If you're watching this, sorry, Taylor. But I always try and make sure that I keep my wallet just right on there on that nightstand, and then I have my keys just hanging right there. So it's super easy for me to find them, and then I don't have to waste time looking for them. So just make sure that everything has a space for you to put it. And obviously you won't be putting those things in the same space every single time, but by trying to continue to put it in the same place, then it'll make it easier for you to keep track of everything and keep everything organized. You should also set up routines for you to keep stuff organized. So whenever I get home, I set my wallet right there and then my keys right there. Easy peasy. Whenever I wake up in the morning after I make my breakfast and whatnot and come up here to brush my teeth, while I'm using the mouthwash, I then make my bed. And whenever I cook my oatmeal in the morning, after I put it in the bowl to let it cool down, I then wash the pot that I cooked with. And then for dinner, after I eat, I then wash the dishes because I don't like them getting piled up like they were. And like I said, those are not my dishes, okay? I immediately wash my dishes. I do not. It's not me. I wish they were better though. And then lastly, if you are going to throw away things, then you probably want to limit the amount of things that you are bringing into the house. So limiting new purchases and whatnot. And the biggest thing for me, or the biggest problem that I have, is getting stuff on Amazon. And I know that's the case for a lot of people, just because super easy 2-day shipping, sometimes 1 day, and they even have same day shipping now, I think. So what you should do if you see something that you like on Amazon, you should put it on a wish list. And then I would recommend waiting like 30 days to see if you actually need it. But I know Matt Diavella, the YouTuber, waits like 7 days. So whichever works for you. If you have a really big problem with spending, then I would definitely recommend the 30 days. Also, if you're someone that goes out and frequently shops at malls and department stores and those sort of things, then I would recommend limiting how often you do that. Probably, I would say this one is definitely at least once a month. I hardly even go like once every 6 months. So if I can go that long without buying something, then you can go at least 1 month. But those are all the decluttering tips that I have for you. So let's get into decluttering my space. I am going to be going through my clothes first. I already actually went through this and I have 2 bags over there already full, like 2 months ago that I already sorted, but there's still a couple more things that I don't really wear that much that I can still throw out and make some room in here. And I'm actually going to be destroying this here in a little bit. And if that works out, then you should already know that because that's what the thumbnail should be. My mom also gets me a bunch of themed style socks. Like there's these Santa ones and these dice ones. And I mean, I'll keep these Santa ones for Christmas time and whatnot also because it's Santa lifting weights. And so it's kind of funny too. But all of the other themed socks, yeah, I don't really have much use for, I guess you could say. Sorry, Mom. I'm also just gonna go ahead and take all this stuff out of this drawer because I do have a new, what's it called? I can't think of, I have a new place to put the clothes that I put in here. So whenever I destroy this, I mean before I destroy this, I'm just gonna go ahead and put all this stuff in there. So, I think I haven't talked about why exactly I am going to destroy that thing, so let me just do that real quick. So, as you may or may not know, I don't know how often I've mentioned it, but I'm going to be moving to Korea next year in February to go and teach English over there. So, I want to make sure that my blarg is very easily transportable so that whenever I go to Korea, it's super easy for me to just take it apart and then take it over there. Because as you could see with me struggling to move it, that thing is a little heavy and it was also kind of old. And from our last house, it had gotten a lot of water all over it and it was starting to chip away at the paint. So it was also ugly. Not a thing that you want to bring a girl home to, if you know what I mean. I've got something that is a lot more compact and easy to transport and I'm gonna assemble that now. See, I can lift this with ease. That's how much this thing weighs. I don't feel like going through this whole process, so. Whew. That was actually a lot more work than I was anticipating, but the product is now done. Yeah, no, it's not like super fancy or anything, but it's gonna get the job done and it's gonna be a lot easier to move whenever I actually need to do that, because I actually am going to have to do that one time before I go to Korea. Now let's continue on with the decluttering. Actually, first, let me just put away these clothes. Ooh, this one is super sentimental because it has Shea on there and then the Irish charm. And I'm obviously Irish and Shea is obviously my family name and my mom got me this a long time ago and I wore the hell out of it. But now, for a while now, it has been pretty small on me. The last time it was worn was probably with my ex-girlfriend like 3 years ago. I let her wear it, then she gave it back to me whenever we broke up. So thankfully, it wasn't a bad breakup and she didn't burn it. But it's now time to get rid of it because it's been too small for me for a while. Some of this stuff in here isn't even mine. My little brother is also one of my roommates, and he uses this room as storage for some of his stuff. So this bag right here, that blue one, that one's his, and then that Christmas tree, that one's his. I don't ever put much out during the holidays. Especially, maybe if I had a girlfriend I would, but since I don't have anybody that comes over here, I only go to my mother's house, then there's not much of a reason to. So now we are going to do my kind of bookshelf, just these storage cube areas. We're gonna start off with the books, some of which I am going to throw away and others I am going to store because I'll probably end up reading them in the future. In that time, I actually mean it with books, but there are some books that I know that I'm not going to. And the ones I'm going to store for later, I'm just gonna put in this box. So after that, most of the books I am going to be putting away for me to read later. And I'll be honest, probably with a lot of those, I won't end up reading them, but I am just hopeful for them. But there are some that I'm going to be throwing away. So these right here, I'm going to be throwing away with that stack. But then this entire box is going to be stored so that I can read it at a later date. But you can see the dent that it made on my shelf. 2-4 empty squares and then 2 that are filled up with books. And then actually a lot of these up here I'm just saving for my little brother because he is getting interested in psychology, and that's what all of these have to do with. Well, I mean, some of them have to do with families and marital stuff, and he is also potentially interested in counseling. But then starting from here to there, and then all of these down there, I am just saving for myself because I probably plan
on reading those pretty soon or using them for a video or that sort of stuff. So now we'll actually finish organizing the rest of this shelf. So that is pretty much all of the decluttering and organizing that I'm going to do in this room, because everything else is pretty good and where it's supposed to be, especially in my work area. But let me just show you how much stuff I am going to get rid of. And keep in mind that I am a pretty uncluttered person and I do like to keep what is essential to me. And I mean, it has been a recent trend to where I start to throw things away regularly, but there is still quite a good amount of stuff that I'm going to be throwing away, even though I've already done that. So this is the pile of all the things that I am going to be throwing away. I've got boxes there, and then a whole bunch of stuff in there. Some, all those books. I guess I should probably donate some of those books as well, but then that, and then there is actually stuff in there. That's where I put all of the linen closet stuff, and then there's all those clothes, and then that jacket that is pretty worn out. So as you can see, it's still quite a bit of stuff, so you can only imagine what it would look like if you do have a lot of stuff that has been built up over time. So what are you waiting for? You should probably get started. I'll see you in the next one. So it's been like 2 weeks since I recorded everything else because I've been waiting for a good day to get outside, but the day is finally here. I'm going to be destroying my dresser, and I've got my little brother out here to help me today, so he'll be making some cameo swings with the axe that I bought just for this occasion. Just a quick disclaimer here, don't try this at home. And if you happen to try this at home or anything like this, make sure you're wearing safety glasses, not sunglasses. And if you happen to not have any sunglasses, I mean safety glasses, then just make sure you have on some glasses, because you know. Well, that about wraps up that dresser. So now we just gotta clean it up. I don't remember what I talked about much in the video that I actually recorded. So have a great day.